A community project led by British soldiers in Kenya has resulted in some extraordinary developments. The country's first ever Maasai warrior cricket team, a campaign against AIDS and female genital mutilation, and a documentary film telling the whole story. It all began when soldiers from the Queen's Gurkha Engineers built a cricket pitch in a remote village, not only to refine their own skills, but to further the British Army's commitment to cultural change in the area. Major Mark Baker was in charge of the project. We'll speak to him in a moment. But first, let's give you a flavour of the film.
This community, we have ignorance.
Let's have the voice also of the women through them.
Major Mark Baker, welcome. I bet that brings back some memories.
It certainly does.
How did it all start? Why cricket and why Kenya?
Well, firstly, the squadron was in Kenya on a 3-month construction exercise. We were constructing some tasks for the British Army training unit in Kenya. And they have a list of tasks which they offer up to squadrons like ourselves to go out and engage with the local community. We selected this task. Being an engineer squadron, we have the ability, the skills to go and construct.
And it just had cricket pitch on the list, did it?
And it just had cricket pitch on the list. We'd played a game against the Maasai before we actually undertook the construction. And I think for the Maasai, they... it might sound a bit coy, but it sort of laid down their spears. And, you know, there's analogies in the film to the ball replacing the spear and the bat becoming the shield. So, you know, for them, it was a medium that they then take forward.
Now, can you explain how cricket was being used to spread awareness about AIDS and female genital mutilation? It sounds a strange combination.
I think, as you can imagine, given the remote location, but sort of deep in the heart of Maasai country within Kenya, you know, when a cricket match takes place, it attracts a wide audience, both of locals, but also from a wider field. And so that's an opportunity. There are a number of stands around the pitch, so there's an opportunity to do AIDS testing. Nurses come in and carry out those sorts of functions. But then the forced genital mutilation issue was really about, I think, exposing to the elders of the Maasai community this sort of growing confidence in the Maasai youth to then go and sort of challenge the practice and question whether it's still appropriate in this day and age.
And did you get the impression that it is really changing attitudes?
Yes, throughout the film, you'll see in the conclusion that having come to the United Kingdom to play in the Last Man Stands tournament, the Maasai team then returned to Kenya. And they're able to go and engage with their elders to have a dialogue. And the outcome of that is that the practice is dropped.